Today, you're gonna learn one of the best ways to end your music at almost any point without it sounding like absolute trash, because nobody actually wants that. So, Freddie, roll the intro. Hey, my name is Billy Rybka, and I'm here to bring you the top tips, tricks, and how-tos for creating better overall videos. So if you wanna take your videos to the next level, then click that subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on anything. And also stick around to the end of the video, and I'm gonna tell you how to get the DaVinci Resolve starter kit all for yourself. So on our timeline in DaVinci Resolve, we have our video, and then we got the music right here. So to do this effect, we have to find a place where we want our song to end. So when I listen to it, it sounds like it's actually a pretty fantastic place to end the song. So I'm just gonna make a cut right here on the clip and delete everything to the right of it. So the issue right now is that it abruptly stops. And that does not sound good at all. But honestly, I wanna go out on some style here. So this beat right here is the one that we wanna end our song on. So I'm gonna make a cut at the beginning of the beat. Now duplicate the audio by holding down Alt and dragging the clip down. Then I'm gonna right click and select new compound clip, then just hit create. So once we do that, open up the effects library and then just type in reverb. Then drag it onto the duplicated layer and the reverb panel is gonna pop up with all of these different settings right here. Now under the room size, I'm gonna grab the bottom point right here and I'm gonna bring the room size down to about 65 to 70 meters, give or take, you know, a little small room. Now that's a huge friggin' room. That's massive. Anyway, by default, our reverb time is set to 950 milliseconds, but I wanna just extend that to around 2300 or so. So this just changes how long our reverb effect is actually gonna be. So feel free to change it up and fit your needs, because quite honestly, 2300 milliseconds is not gonna work for everybody. Next, under our output section, we have this dry slash wet setting. And I don't know why they actually named it that. It sounds kind of weird. However, this essentially is how strong the reverb effect is going to be on our clip. So 100% is gonna be the max reverb. And it's gonna be way too overpowering. You're not gonna like it, your mother's not gonna like it, and the dogs are not gonna like it. So let's just not do that. So I'm gonna bring it down to about 65% for this one in particular. And of course, each sound and song is gonna be different. So you may have to add more, you might have to add less. It just depends on what you're actually doing and what you're working with. So once we do that, I'm gonna close this out and we're just gonna take a quick listen here. And it stops just as abruptly. And that's because since we made this into a compound clip, we're not able to extend it and not have other sounds mess up our reverb effect. The effect's over, I'm done, I'm going home. See ya, doesn't work. Nah, I got you. Anyway, we're gonna have to give this reverb some room to work. So I'm gonna right click and select open in timeline. And then I'm gonna go and duplicate this audio once again. But this time, I'm gonna grab the end of it and extend it a few seconds. And then I'm gonna hit D on the keyboard, and this is actually gonna mute it. Now the reason why I'm doing this is because when I go back to the timeline, I can go ahead and extend my compound clip since I dragged that clip out and muted it inside. But because we muted it, there is no sound after the beat. So if I take a listen to it, you can hear that it now has that reverb effect out just like we want it to. Now, if you want this reverb effect to be a bit shorter, you have to open the reverb panel up and decrease the reverb time, and that's pretty much it. You'd be good to go right there. But I want to really fine-tune the sound of this reverb, so I'm going to switch to the audio tab, then turn on the equalizer. Now under band 4, turn that on and hit the drop-down arrow here and select this kind of curve right there, like you want this one. Okay, I don't know what kind of curve that actually is. So if anyone knows, let me know in the comments. Now I'm gonna grab band 4 and bring it down just like so. And you're gonna hear that it actually is cutting out the 16K frequencies. And I could do it to the opposite as well and increase the 16K frequencies. And depending on the song, you may have to use the third band instead of the fourth because it's using a different frequency. So just move the different bands around and see what you come up with. Now, if you're looking to speed up your DaVinci Resolve learning process, create videos faster, or you just want to support me and this channel and what we're doing, check out our DaVinci Resolve starter kit. Now, we have some of the most popular packs in there, along with our training guide that will help jumpstart your process. Normally, this will go for like 150 bucks, but today it's gonna be 37 bucks. So check that out in the description. And also, we're putting out some pretty cool updates soon, so be on the lookout for that. Anyway, if you want some awesome time-saving tricks, then click on this top video for 10 epic tricks in DaVinci Resolve, or click on this bottom video instead. Anyway, till the next one, peace.